Good morning, Rock Hounders. Shoot this little opener out here outside so I don't put everybody in danger trying to do it going down the highway. That nose hair shot isn't the best anyway. A little noisy out here by the highway, but we'll deal with it. Anyway, I was sitting around last night flipping through my agate books, and that's usually about all it takes. I looked at today's busy schedule and nothing on it but rock hounding, so stick around. I'm gonna jump in that big old black Dodge and head her north. See if I can find me some agates. Come along. You wanna go rock hunting? Yeah, you can't go. You stay here and keep an eye on the place. I see what I can get you. Try not to get political here, Pat. World famous Trinary Bakery right around the corner. Right there. And we're headed for Trout Lake. Hey, loudmouth. You recognize me? Yeah, I feed you down on the other side of the river.
We're up here at Trout Lake. Little loudmouths. This is one place that I want to agate. This is pretty much the headwaters of the Whitefish River. It's all spring fed. This is what brings all that nice water down through my yard. I'm probably about 45 miles straight north of my house as the crow flies. This runs right through my yard and empties out in the little baby knock. Then to the north, pan around here, that way is the Yautrain Basin, maybe 20 miles to Lake Superior. This is quite a gorge that was cut through here thousands of years ago. Being so close to Lake Superior, I wouldn't be surprised if there ain't some agates down here. Hey, you bunch of loudmouths. Got any agates down there? I don't know if I can get down there, I'll bust in my butt. I wasn't planning on looking here. But man, I'll tell you what, look at the color of the rocks. Wow, I think this just might turn into a rock. Coming in, guys. Boy, you wouldn't do this if it was the spring of the year and they had young. They'd be all over you like a wild gobbler in the spring. I just had to get in here and look. I'm already seeing something here. Got my interest. Jeez, man, I think I found a new agate beach. Okay, I made an honest effort. It is so cold out there. Did I tell you how cold it was out there yet? So I just want to take a few of these from Trout Lake home and clean them up. There's two here that this got possibilities right here. I want to clean this up and I just kind of spark my interest. This is probably the best hope I've got. No, I don't do no good. It's got some jasper, it looks like, running through it. Clean it up, take a better look. This big old orange bomb here. of this. A big old piece of chalcedony here. Kind of what it looks like. Then there was this one. It's quartz and jasper. So anyway, that is a spot worth taking a look at when it's about 50 degrees.
Bad mama jama out there today, baby. That's only a 15 mile an hour wind out of the northwest.
Well, I'm at my final destination and it's not looking too good. And if I get on here with that snow line, I'm gonna get soaked. Might turn into dry rock hunt. It's fractured and that right there got my interest. Oh yeah. Little. Blind squirrel can find a nut once in a while. I like that spray pattern on it. There's a sea maggot. Oh, look at the color on that. Jeez, I think I see banding. Lick that rock, he says. Oh yeah, I see a little bit of banding. Oh, I can't wait to get a closer look at this. Banding right there. And a big one. That's different.
the blowhole. Color there, it's kind of cool.
Agate there, baby. A lot of these carnelian looking pieces today.
It's nice, it's got the laminate staining. Pitting. The waxy luster. That can ride home in Pat Muffler's truck anytime. Well, that looks like a agatized jasper. But they tumble up pretty nice. Agate hunting is just like fishing, trapping, deer hunting. As soon as it gets cold, the weather gets bad. The meek stay home. The rest of us go out and get agates. Agatization. This big old dude right here. That's a toad. A big old seamer of some kind. Possibilities. The water level. I don't know if it's a water level jasper or definitely a water level agate of some kind. See those bands or not. I thought it was.
kind of cool. I'm gonna take that one with me. Bingo. Land of the sea maggot. The look to this brecciated jasper right here. I ain't being too picky. I just want to take home a bunch of rocks for the tumbler because I got like $300 worth of grit coming in today. I'm gonna be a rumbling, tumbling fool. What's that right there? I got a rock with a big chunk of this coming out the side of it.
Agates on the brick wall. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. I'm getting that Dodge and pointer south, and I'll get them rocks cleaned up for us and do a little slideshow like y'all do at the end, and we'll be styling. See you in Rapid River. Okay, let's take a little look at what we got here today. These are interesting. Took them over in the shop and give them a little bath and some uric acid and water mix and cleaned some of the crud off of them. Only took about half hour, 45 minutes. These are the rocks I picked up at Trout Lake today.
this is cool. It's like a, I don't know, I'm not gonna call it quartz. It looks more like chalcedony to me, but I'm no pro. I'm new at this. But it's kind of cool. That green is almost like a little bit of moss. And it's got some wild colors in there. I'm pretty happy about this Trout Lake find. I only got about, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7 rocks here. But this is way inland from Lake Superior, like 25 miles probably. I said 30 earlier, but it's probably about 20 or 25 miles in. And if I can find rocks like this summer, I'm gonna put on my waders. This is cool, isn't it? That's gonna polish up. I'll run that down number one till it's perfect. But I'm gonna get up in there with my waders this summer and we'll start working my way downstream. And then look at the pudding stones I'm finding. This one's all red jasper and quartz. And then this one has got that black, I forget what you call that. That's usually in with a jasper and the quartz. There's the jasper, quartz, and that black stuff. But this is, it's where this green is coming from down there in that area. Interesting. And then this, we got us an agate here. This is definitely a little moss agate with some jasper in it. That right there, get me searching that river a lot closer. Wait till that ice comes out and I can jump in that jet boat and cruise upstream. Oh, whitefish ain't seen nothing yet. And this, I'm not a granite person. It's just a little piece of granite to me. It does have a little inclusion in it there. Some people might wet their pants over it, but I ain't. Picked up a few decent ones up there on Lake Superior today. Nothing real great, but a lot of sea maggots. Jack it up a little bit there for you. This old people, so we can see. Yeah, some sea maggots. This one. Excuse me. This one right here. Trying to get something going on in the agate department. Once it goes through a tumble, we'll find out. Boy, that acid. That's why I like acid. If it's not an agate, it kind of shows you where the bear shit in the buckwheat, because it eats everything else away. But the agate remains in that piece. Laying there, these are nice. I tumble these way down, and the agate really starts to show. Most of the time, it's all the way around the rock. Here's a brecciated jasper agate. Got a little bit of fortification going on in it. I looked it over a little bit ago. Not much, but it's a hard rock. It'll tumble nice. I like these. Always tumble good. This is what I call nodules. Quartz nodules. Agate inside. Almost like plume and moss. hard. That's what I like about them. So they'll come real good. I like these Druzy quartz. So these are some of the rocks I picked up there today. This one's kind of cool. I don't know what it is about me and green today, but I got into some green. This is kind of cool. What else we got here? Well, this one was kind of neat. Lots of jasper agates. But you know what? Man, they really clean up nice. Sometimes they reveal nice stuff. Well, look at this. This thing reminds me of a toad. This is gonna reveal a lot, I think, when it goes through the first week. Supposed to have a bunch of grit coming in today, never showed up. It's got that called laminate staining. Some call it peanut butter or mustard. Looks more like mustard to me. If you're eating peanut butter, that's color. I put it back on the shelf. These jasper agates, these polish up so nice. I got lots of these, and I'm gonna run a bunch of rocks in a big tumble. I mean, number one for like 3 or 4 weeks. I got a bunch of stuff like, look at this. This one was pretty cool. Wish those were eyes, but they're not. I don't think. Oh, look there. Little agate stuff going on. That's an eye. A couple eyes there. Oh, yeah. See, that's what I mean. Get these babies tumbled up and they really reveal. Wow, look at that. I didn't know that. I knew it had all the right makings when I picked it up. Look at this big old bomb here. So I think I'm about ready to wrap this agate hunt up for March 3rd, 2021. Little trip up through the woods, headed north, stopped at Trout Lake, looked for agates with the swans. Those were trumpeter swans, by the way, not mutes. Mutes have, when they're sitting in the water, they're shaped like a big S, and their feathers stand way, it looks like their feathers stand way up. So a bunch of trumpeters. They're an invasive species around here now. Let's start the season on them before too long. Thanks for watching. Hit the like and share button and all that good stuff if you would for me. So I get an idea if anybody's watching these besides me. Thanks for coming along.